Alan Shedd. I work for Jackson EMC. We're an electric utility, electric co-op in Georgia, a little bit north of Atlanta. This is my plug-in hybrid Prius. It's a 2004 model. I've driven it for 3 years before we converted it to a plug-in hybrid. Since converting it in early February, I've driven it 19,000 miles as a plug-in. In here you can see the stuff that comes from Toyota. This is a gasoline engine, a little four-cylinder gasoline engine. The electronics that drive the electric motor is in that box, and then the electric motor that drives the car is under that. As part of our conversion, we really didn't make any changes to the drivetrain. It's still stock Toyota. The main changes we made are in the back of the car, where we've changed the battery. Okay, back here is the thing that makes this car unique. Probably the most important feature to the average guy is the fact that now we can plug this car in. It plugs into a standard electrical outlet. Doesn't require any special charging infrastructure or anything. Regular extension cord. Takes about 4 hours to recharge it. 4 kilowatt hours of electricity. On my home rates, I pay about 40 cents to recharge it. And that gives me enough electricity to drive about 30 miles on electricity or a combination of electricity and gas, depending on my speed. This big black box is what holds the new battery pack. We took out the Toyota factory battery and replaced it with a much larger lithium-ion battery pack that stores a total of 9 kilowatt hours of electricity, enough to run your house probably for a day. Over here in the corner, that yellow box is the charger. That's what is connected to the plug and recharges the battery pack. It's cheaper to recharge the battery using electricity you buy from the utility than using gas to do the same thing. Running the car on electricity is like buying gasoline at 75, 80 cents a gallon instead of $3 like we were paying now. So that's really where the savings come in. This display you're seeing up here on the dashboard is actually part of our research project. This is a 2-year-long project we're doing with, sponsored by the Cooperative Research Network. And this thing records about 100 different parameters in the car and reports on how it's doing. The numbers you see here right now are representative of my drive up here. I drove up from Atlanta yesterday. And from the last time I filled up, almost 180 miles ago, I'm averaging 49 miles per gallon. And I burned, you know, 3.6 gallons. So, I mean, the obvious question is, gosh, why is that 49 miles a gallon when it says 100 miles per gallon on the back of the car? What's up with that? A lot of those miles are interstate miles. I mean, basically, I filled up down at where Interstate 85 and 95 intersect, and most of that drive was at highway speeds with the cruise control on, the air conditioner on. The real benefit from the plug-in hybrid comes during that first 30 miles, not the rest of the trip. So on a long trip, I'm typically seeing, you know, mid-40s kind of gas mileage.